Hello everyone, this is Sudipto from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. In today's video, I'm going to talk about a very important topic in API testing that is called mock servers in Postman. So if you are someone who is involved in development and testing an API, you know how important it is to have a reliable and efficient way to test an API. And that's where the mock server comes in. So in this video, I'm going to show you how you can create a mock server in Postman, configure it, and use that in your project. So without any further delay, let's jump in. So here I am in my Postman workspace. The first thing that we need to do, we need to go on this mock server on the left hand side and click on this create mock server. Once you do that, this is a section where you configure your mock server. First is like what will be the request method. For example, you can choose like get, post, all the available HTTP methods. I'll start with get and then let's close that. I'll start with get and let's say you need to give a request URL. So let's say I'll give hello name. Response code is 200 and then here in the response body, I want the response to come as my name. Click on next. The moment I do that, I need to give mock server name. Let's give name as hello world. I want things to be stored in my environment. So I'll click here. Save the mock server URL as a new environment variable. I'll choose rest of the things as default. I don't want this server to be private. I want it's just a public one. And then create mock server. By doing that, it will give me an URL through which I can call the mock server. Now let's use that in here. And then put hello name and click on send. And as you can see, I got a response back, Sudipta Dev. So my mock server is ready and I can use that to do my API testing. One important thing to remember is it will give you a collection. If you go to your collection section, you will find there is a collection already created by default for you, which is Hello World. And under that, you will find this Hello World. You click on that, you will see everything is ready. Your mock server URL is already getting stored inside this variable URL. And now if you click on send, you will get the response back. And also this response is stored under this get URL. So let's say now instead of sending this text response, I want to change to JSON. I can easily do that. I can go to this default, which is basically the response which I saved. And here I will select the type as JSON and replace this with this new one where it is a JSON response and save that. Next time when I'll execute the same one, instead of getting a text response, I'll get the JSON response back. Another thing that you can do with Postman is that you can go to the mock server, click on the server, and that will show you all the logs, all the requests that came to this mock server. You can expand each request and find out the request header, body, response header, and the response body. So that's how you can configure your mock server and test that during your development. And when your API team is done with their development, they will give you the actual URL of the API. You can literally go to this environment variable and change to the actual URL of the API and start calling. Your development will not dependent on the development from the API team. They can work parallelly. So this is the biggest advantage of creating a mock server so that you can continue with your development without being waiting for the other team or the API team to come up with the actual API. I hope this short video is helpful. Please hit the like icon and share, and also please subscribe to my channel to get update about all my upcoming videos. Till then, thank you. Bye bye.